I know of really good Muslims who are lovely people. And I know of people who read Salat 5 times a day, but they're so horrible, I wouldn't like to mix with them. I promise you, I'm sure you know some people who dress appropriately, they read 5 times Salah, they'll even make tahajjud, but they have no way of character and conduct with the people. They cheat and deceive and steal, and they harm others. And yet you have some who might not be so externally religious, but they are so beautiful in their ways and habits and so on. That is all part of the test. You must keep on calling towards goodness without losing hope. If you believe you're a Muslim, you've seen your sister or brother who's a Muslim participating in something wrong or consuming alcohol, it's your duty to beautifully convey the message. That's what I do all the time. We talk about goodness and we do not lose hope. If you see carefully, if you try and look carefully at my social media presence, Twitter for example, maybe Instagram for example, Facebook for example, there is a consistency in positive messages throughout. I try my best not to let negativity be shown, because everyone needs hope today. We're living in a hopeless world. I'm so sorry to say that. Everything you look at is trying to snatch your hope away. Everything you look at is making you despondent. At least you keep on smiling, keep on having a good message, keep on trying, you know, and keep on reaching out to people. It will make you feel good and it will help others. Trust me, I am so moved by the fact that Honorable Minister here has actually said that he follows quite closely on a daily basis and he receives a bit of that motivation. Subhanallah, I'm sure it may be the same with all of you. Well, if that's the case, this is what makes us brothers and sisters in faith. And this is why, please, don't be judgmental. Everyone who is sinful is potentially a really lovely person. They would come across, if only you made the right effort. Keep on doing your da'wah in a positive way. Please, don't go around and say, you know what, you're going to hell. I remember the young people, there was a time when no one used to want to listen to religious scholars. You have a religious scholar coming in, no, the attendance is poor. Or it's all old people ready to go into their graves who are there wanting to know, how do I go into my grave? Why? Because there was a gap. They used to come to the masjid and say, right, the punishment of Allah is severe. You are going to the fire if your hair shows. You are going to the fire if you are going to do this. If you go to the nightclub, that's it. You're doomed. No hope. So the man thinks, you know what? I'm doomed. I'm going to the fire. I've got a place in the fire. Let me just make that place a little bit bigger, so at least I have some space to move, you know. So at least I have some space to move. So what happens is, they are doomed, they feel doomed, they feel bad, they feel evil, they feel negative, they don't want to listen to the message ever again. And they already feel, religion and me, we are two different things, I'm sorry, you know, let's see what happens when I die. But there, now we are trying to change that by giving messages of hope. Allah is forgiving, Allah is merciful. You know, no matter what you've done, come back to the path. It's a beautiful path. Try and do your most. In the Straight Path Convention that we just concluded, I said in the concluding remarks, if you have moved 1 millimeter, we have achieved. 1 millimeter, why? So long as you are heading in the right direction. Today you will have a leader who's right at the top of his, you know, maybe ministry, like we have the Honorable Minister, or even a nation. He was also born one day. And you know what? He also learned language. He also didn't know how to speak. And then he spoke. People were patient with him. He grew up in an environment. It might not have been absolutely ideal, but he made the most of whatever was there and continued until a day came when worldly success was achieved. And now, inshallah, we will look at the success even of the hereafter. And this is why I'm convinced, when I sat and I heard the Honorable Minister quoting verses of the Quran, I was touched. May Allah bless you. May Allah bless everyone. It's not easy, because a lot of the times you see a minister, you see people, you think, okay, these people have succeeded in terms of the world. But perhaps they may not really be bothered sometimes about the hereafter. That is changing. They are bothered about the hereafter. They want to reach out to people to be able to quote accurately. It wasn't just inaccurately, accurately.